I saw this self-help seminar online. I wasn't gonna buy it, but then I saw this montage of sunsets and clouds, and it convinced me it must be a deeply spiritual experience. Going into the seminar, I didn't know there was anything wrong with me, but then I found out I have all these deep traumas. So I released them, and now I don't feel like there's anything wrong with me. I came back from the most amazing self-help seminar last week. It was so exciting, so uplifting, but now I kind of feel depressed that I'm not there. I think I might have to register for the 6 other seminars this year.
I definitely need to go back again and again and again to get fixed.
Hey, what's up? It's Todd. Today I'm going to tell you something that may surprise you, which is this. I hate self-help. If people, like when I describe what I do for a living, they say, oh, you do self-help? Or they say, oh, you're a life coach? I fucking hate it. I cringe a little bit. Now, that isn't to say I don't support seeking mastery or trying to improve yourself or be your best self or grow as a human being. I support all of that, and I definitely support learning and education. But there's something about self-help that I'm gonna talk to you about in this video that I absolutely abhor, and I think it oftentimes does people more harm than good. So let's get into that right now. So I've said I'm not a big fan of self-help, but I'm a big fan of self-improvement, or as I like to call it, getting good at shit. Okay, so I got good at chess at a young age, at least to the point for my age. I got good at soccer enough to play semi-professionally. I got good enough at poker to play it professionally. I got good enough with money to invest and beat the market consistently for years and years. Got good enough at game to teach it and be considered by many one of, if not the best in the world at this area. So I've gotten good at a lot of shit. But I don't believe in self-help. What I believe in is building skill sets, building aptitudes. And it's very, very important to me when I'm working on something that I be working in a specific area where growth is, there's a goal and growth is very measurable. All right, the problem I have with a lot of self-help is twofold. One, a lot of it's very nebulous and unmeasurable. Two, a lot of it is not actually achieving anything tangible or correcting a specific problem. In fact, if anything, it's finding a lot of problems that may not have been there before, right? See. Self-help, as taught, is very, very commercial, and it's a very easy sort of thing to sell to the lowest common denominator, right? So the easiest way to sell somebody something is to sell them pain, right? If someone feels good about themselves, they don't feel the need to buy anything. But if someone feels shitty about themselves, if someone feels like they're not enough or there's a problem with them or they need to be fixed, now they want to buy shit, right? And so a lot of people in self-help will do this kind of thing where they're like, they'll tell you all the things that are wrong with you. They'll convince you things are wrong with you. They'll convince you need help. And you can see this in a lot of people that go to self-help seminars, we call them like self-help junkies and stuff like that, where basically they start to identify with their maladies, right? They'll identify themselves in the first description as like, I'm a victim of abuse, or I was, you know, never loved as a child. And that's how they identify themselves. That's how they start seeing themselves. That is an awful way to see yourself. And it's not very productive. On top of being awful for emotions, it's not at all productive because it's not focused on the present. It's not focused on what you're gonna do now. It's focused on wallowing in your pain, wallowing in the past, building misery. Building your misery, building your excuses for your failures in life. And excuses feel great. Excuses take all the burden off your shoulders. The problem is, excuses don't help you get anywhere. In fact, they get in the way of you getting places. Worse yet, a lot of people, they go to self-help seminars and they get to mingling with other people and getting to be friendly with other people who are also looking for excuses, seeking out pain, these kind of things, and they start to become professional victims. They start to take on this victim mentality that the reason for their failure is not their fault. And that feels good. It feels good because there's two ways. If you feel like you're a failure in life, there's two ways to start feeling good. One is to become a success, and that's fucking hard. That's difficult. That takes years and it takes hard work, okay? The other way is to convince yourself it's not your fault. And that way you can feel sorry for yourself. And there are very few feelings that are as gratifying to your sense of justice and as gratifying to your sense of self-worth and commiseration and compassion than finding excuses and finding reasons why for your failures, right? If your failure is not your fault, you can feel okay about it. And that's an instant relief. Notice the word instant. Instant relief, instant gratification, instant change. That doesn't actually happen. Instant change is bullshit, okay? Instant temporary change of feeling, absolutely. Instant long-term change in life, abso-fucking-lutely not. Absolutely not, right? Now, some of the things, for example, changing your state, changing your physiology, there is some benefit to that if by changing your state and changing your physiology. You motivate yourself to take action and change your actual situation in the real world. But if you change your state, change your physiology, and you use that as an opiate, you use that as just this feel-good tactic to mask or hide from the world or hide from your pain or your failure, that is not productive, and in fact, it's destructive. It's just giving you a way out. Sometimes your pain is there for a reason. Sometimes your pain is there to motivate you to something better. That doesn't mean that you want more pain in your life. That doesn't mean wallow in your pain or anything like that. But it does mean when you're feeling pain, rather than just think, how can I feel better right now? Think, what is the underlying cause of this pain and how can I get at the root of it? How can I correct the underlying cause? And if on the way, doing things for your physiology, getting yourself in a better state, getting yourself pumped up to feel better, to get out there and do something, to get out there and grow, to get out there and build a skill set, by all means, that's worth it. But using it purely as an opiate or wallowing in your self-pity and wallowing in the support of other people who are wallowing in their excuses, that is not productive and that is not going to help you. So what do I suggest? First of all, pick a specific area. This idea of general self-help, fucking bullshit. I'm a big fan of success with women. I'm a big fan of success with your physique and with your health. I'm a big fan of success with money. I'm not a big fan of general self-help. Because how do you measure general self-help? I've become a better, more spiritual, more enlightened person. How the fuck do you measure that? You can't. There is no measure of that, right? How do you even define spiritual, first of all? But even beyond that, how do you measure spirituality? Is there a spiritualityometer somewhere out there? It doesn't fucking exist. But if you're defining it as success with money, well, there's a measure for that. How much is in your bank account? Are you achieving your financial goals? Are you getting your money more passive so you don't have to work as much? If you're looking for success with women, there is a measure of that. Are you, getting more approaches and getting more confident? Are you getting more phone numbers and getting more dates? Are you getting with the type of girls that you want to get with, right? Success with your body, there's measures of that. What is your body fat percentage? How much can you bench? How fast can you run a mile? There are measures of this and you can tell when you're making progress. These milestones are your guides and they keep you grounded in reality through your progress. They also force you to take actual action. They force you to get out of this mental masturbation of, oh, do I feel good? Oh, have I made progress? No, you either have or you haven't, and it's very measurable. And that's what you want to deal in. You want to deal in reality and facts in your life. And again, is there something to things like various forms of therapy? Maybe in some cases, maybe not in others. Is there something to changing your physiology? Sure, absolutely. As long as it's not an end in itself, but it's a means to an end, right? But end of the day, I'm a big fan of skill sets. I'm a big fan of getting so good on a technical level, getting so good in your understanding, getting so good in what you bring to the table in a particular area that even if you're feeling at your worst, you're still achieving more. And you know what? There's two types of feeling good in life. There's what I call pleasure and self-esteem, right? Pleasure and self-esteem. Pleasure is very easily achieved. It's achieved through opiates. It's achieved through jumping up and down and shouting. It's achieved through injecting drugs into your veins. It's achieved through drinking alcohol. Self-esteem is achieved through deciding what you want to be, deciding who you are and what you want to live by, and taking positive steps even when they're hard so that you know you can do it, you know you can handle it, and seeing true, real progress in the real world. And for me, that's what I've always wanted. And so this idea of self-help is a good idea in principle. It's a good idea in principle. And the word self-help should not be a negative thing, but the way that it's treated at self-help seminars, the way it's treated by self-help gurus, the way it's treated in common parlance and in society at large tends to be more harmful than good because it's a lot of making excuses. It's a lot of instant pill, quick fix bullshit that isn't helping you in the long run.